Hey there, this is just a quick video to show you how to make one of these little fan-powered mosquito traps. If you look real close there, you can see all the carbon dioxide bubbles forming right now. So once I put this outside, it should attract the bugs and biting flies and mosquitoes pretty good. I wanted to make a trap that was a bit of an improvement over the 2-liter one you see on the web all over the place. That one for some people works, but sometimes a lot of people complain that it doesn't work, so hopefully this one will work better. This thing is loading up with more bugs. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is make the little entrance hole where the mosquitoes and bugs will enter. Do about an inch this way, and then cross it an inch this way. And then we'll just fold the points in. Like that. And like that. Alright, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put a series of small 1/8 inch holes along the top here, around it. Alright, just like that. Alright, the next thing I want to do is cut the square on top of the lid for the fan. Alright, now just pop the fan in. It should snap right in like that. Alright, once you've got it in like that, then all you have to do is paper clip off the top. And that'll catch any of the bugs that try to escape through the fan. Just like that. Okay, and that's everything. Now we just go ahead and add the yeast and brown sugar mixture. Crank on the fan and put it outside. Alright, start by adding the warm water. Now just stir in the brown sugar. And finally add the yeast. Just sprinkle it on top, but don't mix it in. Until it's evenly coated. Okay, I just fired up the fan on this thing now. Got the yeast and the brown sugar added. Within about 30 seconds, I can smell the brown sugar and yeast in the air now. Funny thing is, I just had a mosquito in here like 5 minutes ago that I killed, but right before I added this. Shouldn't have killed him. Let the trap do it. Alright, if you look real carefully, you can see all the carbon dioxide buildup in there already. Let's take a look at it now. It's been a couple hours. Yeah, it seems to be working good. Not bad. Okay, I went ahead and switched over to a solar panel instead of a battery. It'll help save the battery and run this thing all day. Yeah, it's still going good. There's probably 15 to 20 bugs in there right now. It's been out here a couple hours. I'll check back in a couple hours. This thing is loading up with more bugs. One cool thing about this is every time I walk up to it, you get about 3 to 4 feet away from it, and you can definitely smell the brown sugar and the yeast mixture. That fan keeps pumping it out. All those bubbles are the carbon dioxide that's being produced by the yeast. Catching a lot of stuff just in like 3 hours, and during the day, that's pretty good. This is the catch in about 3 hours during the day, from about 10 to 1. Use the smallest fan you can, because you just want a very, very light breeze being pushed out and up into the air. Here's a quick shot of the specs on the fan I'm going to use. By the way, if you're using this when the sun's out, just use a solar panel. Direct connect to a fan will save your batteries. Okay, so once again, here they are. They take about 5 minutes to make. Just made from dollar store containers, a $5 computer fan, some leftover screen, and a couple of paper clips. Okay, so just some final thoughts on this trap again. You've got the brown sugar and the yeast mixture there making the sweet smell and the carbon dioxide. You've got the inlet holes and the outlet holes. Only one big enough for them to get through right now, but you can add extras. You got the fan pulling out the carbon dioxide and the sweet smells, filling about half this room that I'm experimenting with this in. And the netting that'll catch any that happen to go through the fan, try to get out that way. I'll experiment with how many of these little inlets to make. I've only got one big enough for them to get through right now. I'll put as many as 2 to 4 on here. Again, just make that inlet big enough so that the mosquito can get through. But then when he tries to get back through the other way, he'll have the trouble of the turbulence in there due to the fan and those 4 points sticking out, making it very difficult to fly back out.